You're listening to the audio production of Leveling Up, 12 Questions to Elevate Your Personal and Professional Development by Ryan Leek, published by Thomas Nelson and read by the author. Please note that you may download an accompanying PDF that provides enhanced materials for this audiobook. To download the PDF, please visit harperchristianaudio.com.
To the life and memory of Ricky Tejada. You were a voice of wisdom during the most formidable years of building my family and career. Thank you for always making sure I kept my eyes on what matters most. This book wouldn't be possible without your mentorship. Introduction. I have a problem. I have this habit of telling people I can do stuff I've never done. Like the one time my friend asked me if I could speak for their company. I said, sure, no problem. She responded, well, what about a full day of workshops? Could you lead our whole staff development day? Confidently, I said, of course. Why? Why in the world would I tell her I could develop her whole staff of 100 over the course of 8 hours on a Monday when all I had ever done for anybody was deliver a 60-minute keynote? I had no earthly idea how to pull it off, but I'm so glad I accepted the assignment. I'll never forget it. I spent one of the 8 hours in the workshop on kindness. Why? Because it's one of the few things you can't get a master's degree in that many companies desperately need. FYI, the company was a bank. I probably should have designed a day around leadership, customer service, and sales strategy for the 21st century consumer. But for some odd reason, my friend greenlighted kindness hour. During that hour, people were tasked with going around and saying kind things to one another as I attempted to prove to this bank how kindness could change their entire business. I kicked off the session by sharing a story with the bank about one of my favorite stores in the world. It's called the 99 Cents Only Store. What I love about the 99 Cents Only Store is that it's 1 cent cheaper than the dollar stores. Life is expensive, and I just like how the 99 Cents Only Store makes me feel. Don't judge me. Once, I went there 2 days before Christmas. It was my goal to track down items that should not be 99 cents. For instance, I found ankle braces that are normally $40 at Dick's Sporting Goods, and I asked the manager, are these 99 cents? He replied, sir, yes, they are 99 cents. I've got two ankles, but I bought three. Why? Because for 99 cents, why not? I was so happy in this store that while I was in line, I told the cashier I would cover all of the items the person in front of me had at the time. She had five items. Do the math. We're at $4.95 plus tax. It's not that generous, but it was Christmas. The woman turned around, looked at me, and said, is this a prank? I said, ma'am, do you think people are going around doing $5 pranks? She responded, are you serious? I said, ma'am, of course, it's Christmas. Then she told me something I absolutely didn't expect. She said, sir, I have never had someone show me this much kindness in my whole life. The point I made at that bank's staff development day was simple. We only have to be a little kind to make a big difference. People live in a pretty mean world. What if we can change it one act of kindness at a time? At the end of that workshop, we did a question and answer session. A woman stood up and said, Ryan, I don't have a question. I just want to say thank you. I grew up in a pretty volatile home. I went to a really competitive college. I just transitioned from another company where I learned that the only way to climb the ladder of success is to pull someone else off. I live in a dog-eat-dog world, but today, you taught me that I could actually get ahead in my career and in my life by being kind. I have never heard anything like that in my life. And if I'm honest, I don't like the person I've become. But today, you gave me a new way to be human. So, no question for me. Just wanted to say thanks for coming. That moment changed my life and career. I learned then that behind a coveted job title and salary was a woman just trying to figure out who she was. And I discovered there are so many more people just like her. This realization is what led me to C-suite executive coaching. I wanted to have a career where I helped people win at work and win at home. Even people who were crushing one aspect of their lives but struggling in others. Often, we're expected to take our careers to the next level while also attempting to manage our love lives, raise children, show up for our friends, and remain healthy, mind, body, and soul. For way too long, work and life have been in this tug-of-war battle in the conversation around work-life balance. It is almost as if we're being forced to pick between being good at work versus being good at life. However, contrary to popular belief, I think you can level up in your career and in your personal life at the same time. For people who want the best of both worlds, some would say you can't have your cake and eat it too. But who buys a cake not to eat it? I think the biggest problem is when trying to find balance, work always gets on the scale first before life. Billions of dollars are spent every year training employees on how to be better at work. Higher education courses are primarily designed to prepare students for their future vocations. Conferences are crafted to help leaders develop strategies to grow their careers. But how many resources are collectively spent on taking areas outside of our careers to the next level? But I believe our careers will grow when we do. It's remarkable the number of successful people who have accomplished so many of their career goals, but don't have five people in the world they can truly call their friends. They're crushing it at work, yet they're lonely in their personal lives. Perhaps the only way to achieve work-life success is to consider putting some of our resources on the life side. In fact, if you level up in your personal life, it'll make leveling up in your professional career way easier. The reverse is not true. When you put all your eggs in leveling up in your professional career, it often comes at the expense of your personal life. What I've learned from speaking at some of the top organizations in the world and working with C-suite executives, MBA athletes, and thousands of leaders is that the people who are consistently excelling in the most important areas of their lives have mastered the art of self-leadership. They have a set of principles set up that allow them to continue to grow. They understand that the growth and development of their lives and careers is their responsibility. They're not waiting for someone else to come challenge them. They've figured out ways to lead themselves when no one else is around. When it comes to your growth and development, you might be tempted to believe it hinges on someone else to lead you well. But leveling up is your responsibility. It starts with you. You are likely in one of two categories. The first is you work for somebody. Most people do. Your leader could be phenomenal, adequate, mediocre, or terrible. A recent survey from job site monster.com polled 957 people over 1 month who were openly seeking new jobs. The company asked why they wanted to leave their current employer. 76% of them blamed a toxic boss for being the reason. Many factors contribute to that, but the reality is, I don't meet many people who say they have a phenomenal leader. If you do, you are part of a very small percentage. Let's call that the top 5%. The remaining 95% of leaders fall in the terrible to adequate categories. It takes a lot to get in the phenom territory. So depending on the category you'd put your leader in, the trajectory of your career could simply end up wherever they take it, if you've put it in their hands. And what exactly is your leader responsible for? Training you on company processes and procedures, casting vision, developing strategy. Okay, that's fine. But are they supposed to transform you into someone who works harder, brings a positive attitude, and owns the mistakes he or she makes? Are they supposed to make you a better friend, partner, spouse, or parent? A better person? That's a tall order, even for a phenomenal leader. Now, let's say you're in the second category, and you're the leader. You started the company, you were promoted, your family owns the business. While there are perks to the position, what often doesn't come with the salary is a leader for you. When supply chain disruptions, labor shortages, and talent retention threaten your business, who's there to calm your fears? When others are asking you for vision for the future and you can't see it, who's there to give you advice? It's hard to go to the next level when you feel like no one is giving you the tools to get there. It can be lonely at the top, right? Whether we're in charge or working for someone who is, many obstacles can keep us from leveling up in work and life. But make no mistake about it, our biggest hurdle is us. I love what motivational speaker Jim Rohn used to say. If you don't like where you are, change it. You are not a tree. That's why I made this audiobook, so people could move up to the next level in their lives and careers. When it comes to the most important areas of your life and career, there are levels to it. Level one, aimless. You have no earthly idea what you're doing or where you're going. You have no direction. Level two, stuck. You can envision yourself doing better, but can't seem to get out of a rut. You might work hard, but experience very little progress. Level three, coasting. You are going through the motions. Your life is on cruise control. You do what you have to do to survive. Level four, developing. You are steadily growing. You've had incremental improvements over the past few years, and your relationships and career have excelled. Level five, thriving. You are operating in your sweet spot. You don't have to do anything. You get to do everything. Level six, mastery. You are doing so well that you're in a place to help others do the same. Can you identify what level you are at in your life and career? You may have different answers for both. We've developed a leveling up assessment at ryanleake.com/leveling up to help you identify which level you're at now and to provide a few resources to get you where you want to be in the future. Most people I sit with live and work around level two and three. They're stuck or coasting. They're in relationships and careers they tolerate. The goal of this audiobook is to help you level up to a place where you feel like you're in such a sweet spot professionally and personally that you can help others get there too. As a speaker and coach, I'm often tempted to give people the answers they need to level up. But what I've learned in sessions with clients from my executive coaching practice is that there's a common thread and frequent statement they use. That's a good question. It's the questions I ask that perpetuate their growth beyond the counsel I may provide. When it comes to leveling up, questions are often better than answers because questions equip people to lead themselves when no one else is around. In this book, I have designed 12 loaded questions that will help you go to the next level in your professional and personal life. These questions often lead you to other questions that ultimately will make you a better person and employee. These questions have been formed from countless coaching sessions, keynote experiences, and interviews. This audiobook's journey actually began with 21 questions. As companies requested me to speak, I would present all 21 questions and let them choose which ones they thought best spoke to their employees' pain points. At the end of the keynotes, I would poll the audience to learn which questions resonated with them the most and why. Sometimes the company would even suggest a new question. Over time, 12 questions have risen to the top as those that help people level up the most. Some of the questions involve you taking a hard look in the mirror, and you'll have to answer those for yourself. Then, there are questions that involve you inviting a friend to the table to give you a fresh perspective. We need the mirror and the friend to level up. While the questions are best approached in order, you can dip in and out of the audiobook. There might be a question that particularly speaks to you more than others. Feel free to begin there. When it comes to the energy and focus you bring to your life and career, there are levels to it. Let these questions be your next level guide when your career or life has plateaued, and you'll find yourself growing like never before.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.